Welcome to another NUCIDA video. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our certified QA experts will reply in time. Tosca by Tricentis is a comprehensive test automation tool designed to automate end-to-end testing for software applications. It is known for its model-based approach to test automation, which simplifies the creation and maintenance of automated test cases. Tosca supports a wide range of applications, including web, mobile, API, desktop, and cloud-based platforms. Let's dive in to learn more about the Tosca test automation tool and unleash the secrets. This video represents the second chapter of the video Tosca Model-Based Automation, which explains the first use case. We also recommend watching this video for a better understanding. In our first video, we went and selected the appropriate input that was needed, provided the rest of the parameters that are there, and then you saw the reusability factor where we can leverage libraries or other steps that are being created by dragging and dropping these. Now, I will take this to the next level of automated testing. This is a web-based application, as I mentioned. When we have automated this particular application, typically a web-based application goes through multiple releases, multiple changes, and prints are there, and you have various user stories that need to be implemented. So, concerning this particular sample application, I will just use that again to build a test scenario for the test case after its build. Thus, I would like to show you what happens when there is a change in the application. When we look at changes, and this is one of the constant things that happens in automation, a project that we are implementing in any of the scenarios that we do. For example, what we have, let's say we want to put the data back again to this one, or I can copy this from here and use this inside the same test case just to save time in entering data. So, I have this release of the application where I have input this data, and when you look at the application, it has those defined values. Now, we have the next release of the application, and here we look at the same automobile user journey or test scenarios. What has happened here? There is a change in the way an object has been added. For example, the proceed button became now next, based on the requirement to make it more logical, and then there is a license plate number that has been added to it and is not mandatory, right? If I place this particular test scenario, for example, or in other words, if I replay this particular scenario, obviously the proceed is something which is not there when we automated it in Sprint 1 with a different set of applications and with a different application interface. But whatever is there, what it is going to do is going to perform that operation on that particular part, right? License plate number is not mandatory. The test case should ideally work. In this case, there is a change, the proceed button becomes the next button. Thus, this would lead to maintenance. Now, I will have to identify the new property, then I will go ahead, put and update that, or put it inside the script and handle that. This particular scenario will run fine, because I have enabled a configuration parameter on this particular test case that is called self-healing. The self-healing looks at the object and its properties that were defined when I was selecting the object that will support the self-healing capability. Then it used those permutations and combinations to uniquely work with this specific object. And what we can do now, I can go ahead and say that I would like to apply the self-healing properties to this particular object, and this will make sure that it gets updated. Yeah, and the values get updated. Now, when I go ahead and replay this test, it will not wait for some amount of time. It will automatically perform this. Again, for the reading's sake, as I change the name of the engine performance, I will be able to change the name or the readability perspective. I can come here again and say this is something that is there, but I don't have to identify anything or save it. I can just go ahead and run this test scenario now. Then it goes ahead and operate on the new release, which is having a new change, where I have interacted with an object which was already there in the script. It did not fail because it helped you to detect the object and to make sure that it was going to run. When you have a web-based application going through multiple changes of the application, self-healing will allow you to assist you in making sure that it is going to run the test cases, not fail it for the first time, and give you a recommendation of fixing that deviation in an automated fashion. It did not add the newly mentioned change. For example, if you look here, we have added a new control, which is the license plate number. This can be easily managed now by coming here and saying, I would like to rescan this particular module. By rescanning it, the facility adds a new control of the application inside the existing module. Again, if you had not enabled self-healing, this particular rescan would have also highlighted that which is not matching to something in the application. You can correct that here as well, or you can go ahead and do that. In this case, I would like to add the license plate number to my existing set in the module and save this. Now, I have applied this mentioned change. What does this feature do? Make sure that this gets added, and when you look at the test scenario, the license plate number is available. Now you can execute that in the right fashion. If you want to execute it now, you can run this in Tosca's scratchbook. So, the test case has been modified to include all the parameters that are required for the test scenario. Again, to make sure that I can maintain this more easily by using the model-based testing framework. This is another use case that I wanted to demonstrate. As you know, creating a test scenario can be done in two ways. First, by scanning or recording the automated scenario and using the no-code approach, a manual tester is providing an input to that particular test scenario. The second one was the maintenance aspect. What I have covered are two important things that come with maintenance. One is the ability to fix an existing test script by using the self-healing capability that we have inside built into the solution. The second feature adds new values or objects that are being added to the screen that can be added to the existing module, which will allow you to basically enhance the same test case and reuse them again and again in the repository. Now, I move to the third use case concerning static data, which leads me to the following question. What if I want to run this with multiple data types? In this test scenario, we have various available vehicles, and I would like to test it with different combinations of data. This can be various things like the make and engine performance, make and date of manufacture, or different ways and combinations of testing that specific application. What can you do? You can just go ahead and, let's say, create a new test scenario. Let me just create a test scenario for this one, but now I would like to use it with different test data. Thus, I'm just saying it's a database, so to speak, a data-related test scenario. Again, I will go ahead and drag this particular test case inside my data or module. What will this happen? I would like to operate on this particular test case and click on Next, but I would like to provide the new test data for this test case. So, I use this test case design to provide different permutations and combinations of test data. Now, I want to run it with BMW, Audi, and Tesla. As you may know from our first video, Tesla was not there in the list, but I had added it as bad data to provide negative tests in our test scenarios. I would like to test that particular combination. Therefore, this particular test case become a template for all the different user journeys that I have defined with the test data set. As I said, these user journeys represent just as an example. There could be different ways to define a combination of tests. We could use the engine performance, manufacture date, price, and different permutations, and combination of these attributes and its available data. For the sake of the demonstration, I have just selected the brand names. Now, once you want to use this test case as a template for the different make of the cars that we would like to test. So, we convert this into a template and track the sheet which is available for vehicle data into the template. Tosca will map out all the sheet's attributes to the appropriate fields in the application. This mapping allows you to have multiple combinations of test cases that can be executed. Now, with this approach, you have created a template that is ready for the test. with these three different makes. Let's instantiate the tests by using this template. Hence, I created three different test scenarios based on this test case that are available now. If you go ahead and add a new test case or a new combination of test data that you would like to test, it will automatically create the other set. If I come here and look at BMW, BMW is a data set that we are executing for the various BMW combinations. Then we have Audi, which will be executing the Audi test scenario. And this is Tesla, which is there. Now we can take this set of test cases and put it in an execution list. For example, if you want to execute it one after another, we can define this into an execution list and run this one after another for this available set of test scenarios. So I will enter this automobile scenario. I should have clicked on an automobile to make sure that this runs again and again. Then I'll go ahead and run that. If you look at this one now, it will start with BMW. That's the first scenario that we are going to test it. We are going to test it with BMW, and BMW will allow us to test that particular scenario for BMW. Then we move on to test the next scenario, which is for Audi. The last one, which is Tesla, represents the bad data and a negative test. But that's what we usually do with applications. We will test it with good data and bad data. In this case, it's unavailable. Tesla is not available in the user list. If you see here, there is nothing that will allow us to perform that operation. And this is what the test cases highlight, that you have passed two test scenarios, and you have failed one test scenario, which is Tesla, because Tesla is not there in the list. Thus, we've executed three test cases in total, and that's where we can execute these test cases seamlessly. This execution list is now highlighting that two test cases passed and one failed. But what would be the reason for the failed test? When you drill down further into the test run details, Tosca will take you to the point that Tesla is not a valid option. If you want to store a snapshot, you also have a facility to give you a visualization that this particular test step failed because Tesla is not a valid option. So that's the reason why you can then easily validate what exactly was the issue when you run that automated test case. Hence, you're able to easily understand why this test scenario has failed, what do you need to do, whether you want to correct the data, whether it is the right test scenario, and all that, right? If you look at the execution list, it has identified, yes, out of the three, two passed and one failed. If you run a set of test cases integrated with the CI/CD pipeline, you will be able to execute these tests seamlessly in your pipeline to trigger and bring back the results to Tosca, reporting how many tests are passed and failed. So, this covers the use case that allows you to run the same user journey with different permutations and combinations of data, allowing you to test various scenarios. This is one of the strengths of Tosca. Tosca differentiates very precisely in the way of categorizing test data. The amount of data that is required for testing can be optimized by using various algorithms that are built into the solution. Whether you want to use all combinations of data, whether you want to use linear expansion, which is the least amount of combination to cover the most user journeys. They can use, leverage, and ensure that to automate and do the testing of the applications, which covers all relevant scenarios. That wraps it up concerning the self-healing of object properties and the combination of test data. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our certified QA experts will reply in time or even produce a separate video about your topic. Please also check out our other over 200 videos about software quality. Happy testing. See you next time.